Please remain standing while our choir sings the national anthem. Good afternoon. At this time, you may take your seats. I would like to welcome you to the Hilton Central School District commencement ceremony for the class of 2023. My name is Casey Kosorik, and I'm the proud superintendent of the Hilton Central School District. I have a few housekeeping reminders and thank yous. To start, fire exits are in the front and rear of the building. I would like to thank our high school music department staff, Mr. Jared Strife, and Mrs. Christine Blonsky for working with our students in preparing our music for today. I would also like to thank Dan Lynn from Northeastern Sound and the rest of the Brockport Cirque staff for their assistance with preparing for today's ceremony. Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the district representatives on stage. As I call their names, please hold your applause until every member of each group is standing. Please stand as I call your name. Dr. Jeffrey Green, Hilton High School principal. Mrs. Kristen Pellini, assistant superintendent for instruction. Mr. Adam Geist, assistant superintendent for business. Mr. Ned Dale, assistant superintendent for Human Resources. Our high school administration, Mr. Mark Driesel, Mr. Michael Legault, Mrs. Laura Malta, Mrs. Carol Zelagis, and Dr. Aaron Schneider. District Administrative Representatives, Ms. Tracy Zabadel, Director of Reporting and Compliance, Mr. Mike Jurizzi, Director of Physical Education and Athletics, Mr. Mark D'Amico, Merton Williams Principal, Mrs. Laura Mayer, Assistant Principal of Merton Williams Middle School, Mr. Steven Sorensen, Assistant Principal at Merton Williams Middle School, Mr. Derek Warren, Quest Principal, Ms. Melissa Perkowski, Northwood Principal, Mrs. Sadie Beeman, Northwood Assistant Principal, Dr. Ben Rudd, Village Elementary Principal, Ms. Laura Bauer, Assistant Principal for Village Elementary, and Ms. Karen Spillman, Director of Learning and Staff Development. Board members, Mr. Mark Hilberger, Board President, Mr. Ed Miscadri, Board Vice President, Board Trustees, Ms. Marianne Chafee, Ms. Therese Flannery, Mr. Brian O'Connor, Ms. Nancy Pickering, and Ms. Stephanie Sloan. Our keynote speaker, Mr. Kendrick Krause, mathematics teacher. Thank you to all the district representatives for their commitment to our students and their work in helping our seniors be successful. You may now be seated. One last word of thanks to Hilton High School Principal Dr. Green for his leadership and dedication. He will now continue with further acknowledgments and address the senior class.
Thank you, Dr. Kosorek, for those introductions and for your dedicated leadership of our district. I would now like to acknowledge the class of 2023 advisors and have them stand, Mrs. Donna Johnson and Mr. Matthew Peterinen. Thank you both for your work with the class of 2023. Next, I will have our student selected readers please rise to be recognized. They are Mrs. Catherine Arcerio, World Languages teacher, Ms. Mary Pignato, Business teacher, and Mrs. Erin Williams, Science teacher. And at this time, I would like all current and former faculty and staff from across the district to please stand so that we can recognize you for all of your dedication to these students in front of us over the past 13 years and your participation in this event this afternoon. Finally, I would like to pay tribute to all of our families and guests that are in attendance today, as you have all played a major role in helping our students attain this milestone, and for that, I thank you. So today we are gathered here to celebrate the class of 2023. It is with great pride that I stand before you as your principal for these past 4 years, and I want you to know how much of a privilege for me it has been. I think I have the best job in the world. I want to extend my heartfelt congratulations to each and every one of you as this day marks the culmination of years of hard work, your dedication, and your perseverance. It has been a journey filled with ups and downs, triumphs and challenges, but here you stand, resilient and prepared to embrace the world that awaits you. It's important that you remember that your success is not solely defined by the grades that you achieved or the accolades that you received. Success comes from embracing your failures as a stepping stone to success. Each setback represents an opportunity for growth, for resilience, and the chance to redefine your path. Learn from your mistakes, adapt, and persevere. Remember to be welcoming and affirming of others. The world we live in today needs individuals who can bridge divides, who can embrace diversity, and who can foster a sense of unity and inclusivity. Be a force for positive change. Stand up for what you believe in. Lend a helping hand to those in need. Your actions, no matter how small, have the power to make a difference. Don't forget, you are a cadet, now and forever. And you will always have support here in Hilton. Thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce Mrs. Carol Solages, Assistant Principal, as we move on with the most important part of today's ceremony by honoring our graduates.
Hello, everybody. I'm so excited for this day. Now we will be inviting our honored student speakers to the stage to share some parting thoughts with you. Can both of our student speakers please come up to the stage? Our first student speaker is Class of 2023 Valedictory Honor Speaker Gabrielle Hicks. Gabrielle Hicks is the daughter of Melissa and Kevin Hicks and the sister of Daphne and Joshua. While in high school, she was the president of National Honor Society, played soccer, and volunteered at Seneca Ridge Dialysis Unit. Gabrielle will be attending Siena College as a part of the Science and Humanities program and will attend Albany Medical College upon graduation. She will major in biology and minor in Spanish, which is very near and dear to my heart. I now present to you Gabrielle Hicks.
Thank you so much. Everyone's ready for a bunch of speeches, right? So I would like to start off by congratulating everyone in the class of 2023. This whole graduation thing can be a little bit overwhelming at times. can feel a little overwhelming sometimes. Actually, scratch that, most of the time. I think I have a remedy for that. Sure, it's something we've all thought of, something we've probably taken a few steps forward to try and never quite followed through on. Or rather, a few steps backward. It's time travel. I promise this is practical. Quick, think of one of your favorite moments from elementary school. Here's mine. I'm in Mrs. Castilia's classroom in Northwood. I'm holding my school iPad, something I'm still not certain we should have been trusted with, and recording a fun little science experiment, elephant toothpaste. It's a mini volcano in an old Wegmans water bottle dyed neon pink. What could go wrong? For sixth graders, that answer is anything. Apparently, you're not supposed to put the cap on that water bottle, a lesson another group had the privilege of teaching to our class. A lesson complete with elephant toothpaste sprayed all over half the people there. And, as we later found out, stamped onto the ceiling tiles. Talk about leaving a mark on Hilton. Okay, but we all have our own favorite elementary moments, right? Try to visualize it right now. Maybe you don't see it clearly anymore, if at all. And that's fine. I think there's a reason memories don't last forever. It helps us let go. But you were there at one point, and you can pick yourself up now and drop yourself back in that instant, back when your world and the hallways were both much smaller. Even then, you were trying to travel ahead. Were you that kid who imagined yourself under the lights on Le Beau, your name and number echoing like an anthem in your ears? Did you imagine the art show you would create, one bigger than the one on the walls of your school? Did you picture yourself here today, your cap positioned perfectly and your gown flowing from your shoulders like Superman's cape? Did you realize that your teachers would still be picking your partners for group projects? You shared boundless dreams with friends and little siblings, chattering about the future jobs you'd have and the mountains of ice cream you'd eat when mom wasn't there to stop you. Looking forward is really awesome at times, but it can also kind of suck. We get caught sneaking glances in the rearview mirror, and we start to feel nauseous, homesick for the things we're misremembering. Take a deep breath. You can pull over. Look backward, switch directions for a moment in your mind. And look around you at all the kids you grew up with. They were right beside you this whole time, designing chalk masterpieces on neighborhood sidewalks and turning in assignments just minutes before they were due. Learning to drive just like you were. Turn the radio on. All the songs we screamed together at prom are from those years we shared. All the ones with dances we worked overtime to memorize and the ones with iconic music videos we pored over for hours. I remember freaking out over Reputation by Taylor Swift in the Merton Williams cafeteria before soccer practice. Remember school assemblies and the Christmas and Hanukkah songs our music teacher drilled us in every December? Obviously, when you're really driving, you still have to check behind you. I'm going to bet someone is tailgating you. That's almost as certain as the weather being utterly unpredictable around here. Just look outside, and definitely make sure to wear your seatbelt. But for the sake of this illusion, with your imaginary car still pulled over, put your hands back on the wheel and just look ahead. There's a proper time and place, even for time travel, and it's not in the middle of trying to move forward. You could take a wrong turn, get lost, or get hurt. You can always keep your finger on the turn signal, never afraid to pull over again if you want a second to let the memories wash over you. That little kid is still in there, still a part of you, still dreaming up outlandish scenarios where your Barbie collection follows you into the mansion you inevitably own. It's hard to balance all of that imagination with the chaotic whirlwind of the rest of the world. Sometimes, you need to travel back to a place that kid is more familiar with, one that may only exist in memories, but is shared by you and your friends and siblings and all of the people sitting here with you today. I think that's the greatest thing about going to school here. Graduating is tying the bow on a childhood that might have been rough and a little embarrassing, but is one that ties us all together and will keep us going, regardless of what we do along the way and where we end up. There's a reason I can't talk about some magical lesson no one else here knows. It's because I learned it all with you. Thank you for teaching me, and thank you for raising me. And never forget that you can also pull over to let that tailgater pass.
This time I would like to introduce Hilton High School student elected officer, Isabella Smith. Isabella is the daughter of Ian and Alexis Smith and sister of Ethan and Evan Smith. While in high school, she participated in National Honor Society, Class Council, Best Buddies, as well as the Hilton Theater Program. Isabella will be attending St. Bonaventure University in the fall to major in political science. I now present to you Isabella Smith.
Good afternoon. It is an honor to be speaking at today's commencement ceremony. On behalf of the class of 2023, I would like to thank all of the families, friends, teachers, and administrators for being here to support us as we take the next steps into our life journey. Today we gather to celebrate the accomplishments that have led us to this moment. Although we are all moving on to the next steps of our lives and may feel apprehensive or scared, we're all in the same boat, together. Taking this next step is going to look different for each of us, as the different obstacles we faced throughout our lifetime have shaped us into who we are today. When I was in second grade, I was adamant that I would be a neurosurgeon, but now I'm going to college for political science. So how is it that these dreams we have from such a young age change so much? It's our journey, as individuals and as a class. Without even realizing it, your character has been developing into who you are today from the earliest moments that you can remember. The things as simple as the friends you played with on the playground, being the new student that got bullied, that all builds your character. For me, I was that new student in sixth grade, and instead of letting the people that bullied me break me down, I took it all in and used it to make myself a stronger person, the person standing before you today. Many of my classmates most likely didn't know that about me, and that's because we all have our own lives and our own experiences that shape us. But at our roots, we are still cadets. What we have faced as cadets has also influenced who we are. From ninth grade to now, we've been faced with challenges each year of high school. And not only have we overcome these challenges, but are now thriving because of the perseverance each and every one of us has. Together, we faced a global pandemic that completely altered our first 3 years of high school. But did that hold us back? No. We came back stronger and more united than ever. We're not just any other class. We're the class that kept the Barstool Hilton spirit going this year. The class that packs the stands like no others. The first class of Hilton to say that our football team won the regional championship. All of this happened because of who we are, and that's a direct result of what we've done through our journey up to this point. Continue to strive for your goals because the hard work and memories don't end here. This is just the beginning. Never let challenges dull your spirit. Hilton Class of 2023, we have never let anyone dull our spirit during the challenges we've faced. So carry that same perseverance with you through your future journeys. Use the struggles you've been faced with and our class has been faced with to fuel the fire that will help you reach your dreams. And just like high school, there will be people that support you unconditionally and people that will constantly try to take that fire right out from under you. But stay true to yourself and don't stray away from your dreams, and you'll do incredible things. Thank you for your time and congratulations to my fellow classmates.
As we continue with the ceremony, it is tradition that each year the senior class selects a teacher to deliver the commencement address. This year, we chose Mr. Krause. He is a highly respected faculty member at the Hilton High School who teaches Algebra 2, Algebra 1, Math for Life, and Creative Problem Solving. It is my privilege to present to you Mr. Krause.
Hilton High School, class of 2023. I don't think you know how much this means to me to be selected to be your graduation commencement speaker today. I just completed my 27th year in Hilton, and arguably my most difficult and rewarding year of teaching and coaching I've ever had. To end this year standing before you, one of the most amazing classes to ever pass through the halls of Hilton, is truly an honor. The last time I was asked to speak, though, was in 2017. Fortunately, back then, they asked me to speak in January, so I had plenty of time to work on my speech. This year, I was asked about 4 weeks ago, right in the middle of track season. I eagerly agreed and then immediately started to worry if I had enough time to write a speech worthy of this class and your parents. But you know what? It is 2023, for heaven's sake, and we do have artificial intelligence. So if this speech is great, you can congratulate me. If it fails in any way, it's all ChatGPT's fault. God help the rest of you teachers on that stuff. I have no idea. Before I continue, I've done this before. I'd like to do it one more time. I'd like to ask anybody or any graduating senior that is planning on joining the military, going to school to be an ROTC scholarship, can you stand at this time? Stay standing, please. Just stay standing. Next year, while the rest of you continue off to college or head directly into the workforce, these brave young men and women will be training to protect the freedoms that we all enjoy every single day. I am by no means undermining what the rest of you will be doing next year, but in this day and age when the world is at such a high level of turmoil and uncertainty, it is these young men and women who have chosen to stand between harm's way and our way of life. Before you take your seats, I'd also like to ask your parents, your grandparents, and the rest of family members that are here today to also stand. I would like to publicly thank you for raising such fine young men, such fine young Americans, ready and willing and able to defend our great nation. Keep standing, I'll be done in a minute. The reason I wanted to publicly acknowledge these individuals is because 36 years ago, I too made that same decision. For me, however, it was about maturity and lack of direction. The world in 1987 was not the world it is today. Joining the U.S. Army, for me, was about adventure, finding myself, and, for heaven's sakes, growing up. That was, of course, until my unit was deployed to Iraq in 1990 for Desert Storm. You all have decided, even amongst the chaos that is happening in the world, to join the armed forces and protect our country and, again, our way of life. I can't tell you how honored I am to know you, and I wish you the best of luck in the future. My one piece of advice for all of you is to get started running and working on your physical fitness. This will be paramount to surviving boot camp. For the rest of you, class of 2023, make sure you communicate regularly with your classmates. Make sure they know where they are and what they're doing. If they get deployed, send them care packages and do it regularly. Do this as a class, as it is vital important to their mental, emotional, and physical well-being. Thank you all very much. You can all sit now. Thank you. Graduates of the Hilton High School, class of 2023, I would like to once again thank you for allowing me to speak to you today one last time before you head off to find your calling in this bizarre and ever-changing world we live in. I would like to first commend you for making it here today in spite of all the craziness that has occurred over the past few years. On Friday, March 13th, 2020, a few of the senior girls on the lacrosse team asked me if they thought we'd be back in school on Monday, and if they were going to lose their spring 2020 season. I sort of laughed that off, and I said, of course we're going to be back. And no, I didn't think we're going to lose your spring season. Nostradamus, I am not. You were all sent home that day having no idea what to expect. If I remember correctly, you were all given an early spring break, and there was to be no school conducted for a while. I may or may not have administered a test that following week. If you know me, I have a calendar and I hate to get off track, and it was test time. And for some reason, the kids didn't seem mind taking their trig test at home. I don't know why. After that, it was hit or miss, what you all learned. After that, many of you struggled mentally and emotionally trying to make sense of all this and doing so without being able to be with your friends, hug your friends, or even just see your friends' faces. You were told you needed to stay away from loved ones, especially the elderly and immunocompromised, which means for many of you, you couldn't see loved ones by their side. To say this was a crazy time would be an understatement of the year. The following year, you were split into cohorts for most of the year, wearing masks and trying to learn. I can say with absolute certainty that was the most difficult teaching year I have ever done. As a teacher, all I could do was see your eyes, and I felt like I didn't get to know you and who you are as well as I've done in the past. Being able to read students' faces and read their emotions is something I'm pretty good at, but that year was so very difficult for all of us. But somehow, amongst all this chaos, you have all persevered. Some of you a little more battle-tested than others, but you've all made it. I want to thank you for being so brave under all those absolute craziness. I do have to say, during the grad walk last week, I got a little emotional when I did see all of your faces and realize how many of you that I know very, very well. I'm glad I got to play a small part in your education and lives. Also, during this time, we saw a rise of this craziness, social media. When I was young, I had the fortune of being born to a mother, and especially my father, who grew up very poor, shared his shared very small bedroom with two of his brothers. I heard my dad say with great regularity, "You can only spend a dollar once." When we were young, keeping up with the Joneses was a statement heard over and over again. Keeping up with the Joneses, for those of you that are a little younger than I am, is the idea that you can't always have what your neighbor has or your friends have at school. The Joneses used to just mean your neighbors, just used to mean the friends at school. But now it is every single solitary social media post and every person that is posting online. Every day, young adults are bombarded with posts of thousands and thousands of friends and, heaven forbid, influencers, that you are now having the time of their lives and you're wondering why your life is not as much fun. I urge you to stay away from social media as much as possible. I know, I sound like an old fogey, but what you see on social media is not reality. In the words of a very wise Hilton senior, Cameron Eccleston, quote, "When you are feeling overwhelmed by social media, put your phone down and think of five things you are thankful for," end quote. Ground yourself in reality and don't worry about what others are doing. Enjoy every moment. Live in the moment and live your life like there is no tomorrow. Speaking of your life, now what? For as long as you can remember, you've been bombarded with people telling you what to do, that you have to go to college to make something yourself, that getting a college degree is the only way you can be successful in life. While the unemployment rate might be a little lower for college graduates, it's certainly not the only way to get through school or get to life. You need to follow your own passion and discover what will make you happy. I will tell you, after almost 28 years at this job, I still find myself jumping out of bed every single day at 5 a.m. and can't wait to get to work. I get in my truck or on my motorcycle, crank up Metallica like I'm a teenager, and think about who I can torment in math today. What is your passion? What is going to get you up every single day? For 18 years now, your parents have tried to instill in you the values and morals and work ethics that will ensure you will be successful when you leave the nest. Your teachers have filled your mind with so many different subjects, you found yourself asking, when am I ever going to need this? No math teacher has ever heard that before. We did so in order for you to find your passion. One of the hardest things for most people to understand or comprehend is you don't know what you don't know, and it's our job to spark some light in your life. If you're like me, though, that light was a little lit. The light was not lit after high school. It was pretty much out. Hence my discovery period in the military, which was okay, and it worked for me. So if you decide after self-assessment you want to be a carpenter or go into construction, you go for it. If you love to work on cars and you want to be an auto mechanic, you go for it. I'll be bringing my car in. If you want to be a study to be a fireman or a policeman, please, please, we need more people doing that. You go for it. If you want to be a barber, go for it. I just will not be visiting your shop. Find something you have a passion for and don't let anything stand in your way. If you're not sure what you want to do at this time, know that you are not alone. But never quit looking. Eventually, you will find the spark that will ignite your fire. For those of you that are going off to school, talk to your professors. Put yourself out there until you find the perfect career that will make you happy. Try not to single-handedly improve your school's top 10 status on the party school, for goodness sake, do not try to keep up with the Joneses. It's not reality. I will leave you with this final thought, as summed up best by Robert Mueller. Whatever we do, we must act with honesty and integrity. And regardless of your chosen career, you're only as good as your word. You can be smart, aggressive, articulate, you can be persuasive, but if you are not honest, your reputation will suffer. And once lost, a good reputation can never, ever be regained. Graduates of the Hilton, of the class of 2023, I'm going to miss you all so very much. You are such an amazingly awesome group of young adults that is going to take the world by storm and never look back. Thank you one last time for allowing me to be a small part of your journey.
Seniors, now is the portion of the program that you have been anxiously waiting for. Can I please ask all members of the class of 2023 to please stand? Now that you're all standing, please make sure that your tassel is currently on the right. With the authority granted to me by the State of New York as the principal of Hilton High School, I hereby present to the Hilton Central School District Board of Education the candidates for graduation for the class of 2023. Class of 2023, please now move your tassels from right to left. Congratulations. All but the first row, you may now be seated as we prepare to present to you our diploma jackets.
Gabrielle Rose Hicks. Isabella Julia Smith. Alyssa Kelly Almakinder. Isabel Marie Anderson. Alexis Marie Anderson Monticino. Robert David Ray Calhoun. Sarah Michael Chapel. Alana Sue Conley. Troy Matthew Davis. Annalise Victoria Douglas. Lucas Michael Etzel. Madison Harper Gay. Sean Patrick Cooter. Annabella Catherine Patine. Braden David Smith. Natalie Lynn Whitehair. Ariana Jade Williams. Sorry. Carolyn Elise Adams. Heba Iman Alawi. Autumn Victoria Alexander. Amir El Safadi. Emily Rose Anderson. Alyssa Nicole Andrecki. Vanessa Marie Anselmo. Elena Ray Antinarella.
Gianluca, Bruno, Antonini. Emelissa, Mary Jane Nauer. Jeffrey Howard Aurand III. Carly Corinne Strauss Avery. Kayla Issa Bailey. Desiree Victoria Ballard. Isabella Paige Barnum. Brian Michael Bartek. Sarah Elizabeth Bateman. Anna Carrie Beasley. Paige Nicole Bennett. Jake Robert Bishoping. Kaylee Day Bishop. Leah Joy Yoon Bishop. Vanessa Lauren Blossom. Seth Christian Bodie. Diana Rachel Bore. Tessa Gabriella Briggs. Ryan Renee Briscoe. Jeffrey Broadnax. Max Brock. Ariana Irene Brown. Mackenzie Veronica Catherine Power Buchholz. Allison Nicole Burley. Eric Owen Burton. Yannick Bykovsky. Elizabeth Susan Callen. James Samuel Capolupo III. Joseph Anthony Capria III. Vincent David Capria. Robert Charles Cardone. Bobby Francis Carlson. Ashley Mackenzie Carter. Valentina Marie Caruso. William Salvatore Caruso. Rebecca Lynn Case. Nicholas Peter Castellana. Yep. Alexander James Cavallero Kleiss. Aiden Michael Cowley. Colin Spencer Cereal. Congratulations. Jason Anthony Chapin. Emily Jean Chapman. Juliana Rose Charbonneau. Zachary Robert Charlebois. Alexander Vincent Chierto. Anthony Christopher Chacha. Luke Anthony Ciadella. Cameron Patrick Clark.
Congratulations.
Molly Ann Coles. Mariana Sarada Colon. Erica Kathleen Conroy. Zachary James Codaro. Constantinos Roland Cowan.
Congratulations.
Benjamin Robert Kronk. Gabrielle Nicole Kronk. Zachary Hunter Cresson. Justin Lynn Cruz. Matthew James Cudzillo. Connor Joseph Chippis. Got it. Robert Han Daniels. Cameron Joseph Davis. Carlotta Anna DeStefani. Mustafa Marmon Diaz. Nicholas Gaetano Del Vecchio. Madeline Rose Demshock. Emma Grace DeRoy. Aiden Joseph Duchal. Avery Reese DiUlio. Brielle Janice DiGiacco. Sophia Bella DiLulo. Ketlin Christina Dominguez. Adriana Sunshine D'Amizio. Haley Ann Donahue. Hannah Mary Donahue. Jessica May Donatella. Ryan Michael Douglas. Timothy Joseph Duell. Cameron Alexis Eccleston. Kylie Marie Emmerich.
Lillian Rose Emmerich. McAloom Douglas Emmerich. Justin Michael Enser. Giovanni Santino Essler. Nicholas Anthony Feedy. Logan Jean Farrell. Samantha Riley Fisher. Alexis Camry Foster. Michael Charles Fox. Aiden Zachary French. Meredith Paige French. Christopher Kumar Franzak. Ava Grace Forsini. Vigo Alfredo Fuentes. Veronica Lauren Furioso. Dylan Scott Gage. Shaylin Renee Gage. Annalise Marie Garcia. Adam Leo Gargano. Seamus Edward Gavigan. Mia Ann Melas Geiger. Sophia K. Gizzy. Delaney Rose Goodenow. Skylar Brooke Gotham. George Charles Green. William Edward Green. Leah Paige Grinnell. Reese Benjamin Guck. Abigail Rachel Hom. James Hantess Jr. Rachel McKenna Harden. Carly Marie Hargather. Jonathan Patrick Hay. Evan Hayes Hazard. Owen Michael Hazard. Kevin William Hebert. Michael James Heiss. Sydney Grace Heiss. Ella Sophia Heron. Aiden Alexander Hinman. Lillian R. Hoteling. Natalia Jane Hauser. Ella Grace Howie. Timothy John Hull Jr. Adriana Michelle Iannone. Ryan Hunter Ingham. Connor John Jansen. Haley Jean Jock. Sophie Marie Johnson. Elizabeth Claire Johnson Atoma. Juliet Balloom Karubi. Nathan. Gianni Francisco Kasuba. Alyssa Nicole Kenyon. Alyssa May Kessler. Carl Michael Coons. Emily Elizabeth Kinane. Morgan Shannon Kirky. Jaden Paul Clement. Emma Mary Niddle. Ryan William Krause. Meredith Lynn Cable. Leah Virginia Kunish. Abigail Rose Ledoux. Eli Bennett Lana. Robert James Lan Aponte. Carmela Maria Lanzatella. Jaden Alexander Laurie. Marissa Grace Lay. Sophia Bell Leach. Emma Elizabeth Lenhard. Karina Jo Leo. Peyton Nicole Leslie. Tyler Morgan Letcher. Amber Catherine Lewandowski. Ashley Marie Liming. Emily Ann Liming. Scott James Lingle. Justin David Liucci. Corey Aaron Lombard. Adriana Marie Lombardo. Alyssa Marie Lauza. Lauren Olivia Mangiacapri. Antonio Vincent Manilo. Juliana Christine Marcella. Angelo Pasquale Marcello. Mercedes Monet Marshall. Ella Rose Martina. Lily Marie Mathis. Azalea Sky Lucas. Ethan Julian Scott Matice. Bryn Elizabeth Mazzaferro. Lillian Ray McCormick. Sophie Ray McGrain. Nicholas McMahon. Alan Mihanovich. Eva Meisner. Gianna Evelyn Masura. Ariana Eleni Michaelitis. Chance Richard Miller. Claire Elizabeth Miller. Jordan James Mastretta. Osiris Lazaro Morjan. Aiden Joseph Morielli.
Jacob Mitchell Morrill. Jason Thomas Mosier. Avon Sage Muir. Wanda Marie Muniz. Tyson Sean Moranti. Carly Samantha Murphy. Aiden James Neary. Wesley Shea Nelson. Kiata Giuseppe Neary. Graham Charles North. Carson John Beatty Nowacki. Ashaya Divine Carey. Dylan Jacob Obuck. Joshua Joseph Oliveri. Samuel Sean Ortiz. Ryan Stephen Parsons. Sky Lauren Parsons. Hayden Nicholas Penna. Eliana Marie Pereira. Connor Joseph Pichano. Madalena Grace Pichato. Sarah Ann Pickering. Gabriella Reese Pike. Nicole Charisse Pylon. Luke Anthony Pisani. Gabriella Ann Pitty. Evan John Polendick. Natalie Elizabeth Porter. Jake Joseph Potter. Grace Louisa Preston. Ilya Michael Proust. Joelle Alana Therese Patron. Rianne Maria Ramos. Morgan Marie Rector. Matthew Thomas Reed. Timothy James Reedy. Emily Noreen Richards. Alexander Robert Richmond. Matthew James Robinson. Dominic Orlando Rodriguez. Kyle A. Rosner. Matthew J. Rogowski. Gabriel Alexander Roman. Natalia Elise Roman. Leanne Ronco. Ariana Marie Ross. Jacob Robert Runyon. Deanna Rose Ryan. Taylor May Ryan. Joseph Lewis Santa. Alyssa Rose Schirmerhorn. Jacob James Schindler. Rain Elizabeth Searly. Zach Andre Shanahan. Madison Lynn Shinitsky. Daniel Steven Seachuk. Rylin K. Sidebotham. Nathan Joseph Sidoti. Dylan Jackson Salado. Luke Michael Simonelli. Amanda Ray Simpson. Eliana Grace Sloan. Allie Catherine Smith. Aiden Edward Smythe. Michaela Lily Sobera. Anna Danielle Arlene Sproul. Antonina Stefanishin. Brendan John Stevenson. Sophia Irene Strauss. Charles Robert Strepp. Samantha Irene Streamer. Sophia Ann Streamer. Corey Dalton Schur. Ashton William Tank. Luisa Romina Terminio. Gianna Marie Thomas. Brady Andrew Turpin. Victoria Grace Vellett. Samuel Gregory Vinch. Sarah Trinity Wade. Andrew John Wainwright. Laura Christine Wallace. Clifford Wanke. Nina Rachel Wandke. Andrew Kenneth Ward. Matthew David Wegman. Tiffany Julia Wenzel. Michael John Wheelahan. Nathaniel James Wilkins. Mason Timothy Williams. Sarah Elizabeth Williams. Melissa May Wilmeyer. Matthew Christopher Wilson. Taylor Rose Wilson. Haley Ann Wolf. Kyler M. Woodley. Mason Charles Wright. Angelina Ava Yacoub. John Frank Younger IV. Justin Andrew Younger. Jacob Nash Joseph Sawicki.
Family and friends, please join me as we extend our congratulations to every member of the class of 2023. Seniors who are still in need of a photo, we will do that after the recessional. If you could please head to your seats. Class of 2023, I will ask that you please remain seated until all members of the stage have recessed and your line leader signals you to recess. Audience members, please remain in your seats until the entire recessional has concluded and all of our seniors have exited. Seniors will receive their diplomas in the ice arena and they will be exiting from there. Those still in need of a photo will be able to return for that. I want to thank everybody and hope you enjoy today's celebration of the class of 2023. And at this time, we will begin our recessional.
Hoping you take that jump, don't feel the fall. Hoping the water rises, you built a wall. Hoping the crowd screams out, screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Hey. You built a wall. open, the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. When the moment comes, you'll say, ah.